Hello and welcome to Knitting at Tiffany's with Added Bling. This is episode 39. I'm Tiffany.
I'm Erin.
Thank you for coming back if you're a return viewer, and welcome if you're a new viewer. This is our last episode for the end of the year. How exciting.
Yep, two more days.
I know. I'm so excited.
I can't wait for the new year to start.
Oh, I know. It's going to be great. Yeah. It's going to be so great, especially with everybody that's passed away this year.
Yeah.
All the celebrities.
A lot of people are like, man, 2016 can just...
Yeah.
Go in the pooper.
It's been like a crazy year with that, you know? I mean, Princess Leia, how many people love her? And, you know, I grew up with her too, so it's a little different. And then her mom and then Prince and what's going on? Yeah. Some of these people are way too young.
But not just that, like all the stuff that just like world events and stuff. Like it's just been, it's been a wacko year.
It's been crazy years.
Yeah. So 2017. Come on, 2017.
That's right. It'll be
hopefully
a better year.
It'll be better, yeah.
Yes, yeah. Definitely.
I mean, I had a good year, but just... You know,
yeah, I had a great year.
In terms of the world. But
yeah.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Ready to start.
So new ready year. To start a new year. I love starting a new year. It's funny how time flies by.
Yeah, it went by so fast.
It's just, I can't believe it. It feels like it just was yesterday that it was January.
Before you know it, it's going to be the summer.
I know. It always seems to fly by. I'm good with summer, though.
Yeah, I know.
I hate winter.
With you being sick and stuff, I bet you'll be glad when winter's over.
I can't wait. I'm still fighting this bronchitis thing. It's been a little rough for me. So if I cough today again, I'm really sorry.
Yeah, I should be okay. I've been doing better.
Yeah, I'll warn you. I'm still sorry. I've been babying myself for it. Taking care of myself, trying to not leave the house in this cold weather because that kills me. So we'll see. Hopefully the new year will be better.
Okay.
And you're better. So, what are we starting with today?
What are we starting with? Well, we had a request.
Oh, yes.
From the YouTube channel.
That's right. And that was from Hot Pink Socks.
Yep, Stephanie.
And that is Stephanie. Stephanie wants to see a nail flash.
So, we're going to do nail flash.
Good thing today, Stephanie, I got New Year's nails going on. Ready? Nail flash. Can you see that?
I love the sparkles.
I know.
And is this the silver or is this the gold silver again?
No, this is silver. Okay. This is silver. So, this is silver with my famous OPI pink, and that's the Kiss Me I'm Brazilian. Yeah. I did it again with just the black.
Yeah.
And I always have bling in my nails.
Yeah,
I always have to have bling in my nails. I love them. I shorten them too because, you know, people always say they're always too long, and I don't do it. That I do for other people. They'll never get shorter than this, though.
Yeah.
This is the shortest they'll probably go. But I love them. And so,
cool.
I did New Year's Eve. You'll see.
There you go.
There you go. You can see them. They're pretty. It's like the arrow, with the new, like going into the new year kind of thing, right? I knew there's a little bit of a theme behind it, so yeah, that's for Stephanie.
Okay, and then what are we going to do now?
Well,
we have very little enabling this episode.
I know, isn't this shocking?
I have nothing.
I have one, and I already wound it up.
And she's already working with it, so I don't know if that really counts.
I don't know if it, well, technically it does, but it doesn't.
Technically it's in, but it's going out again, so we're going to start with kind of an enabling /
oopsies,
rough diamonds. Hybrid thing.
Yeah, totally. So this is yarn box I received, and it was yes, thank you.
There you go.
Man. Okay. So this is Feederbrook Farm.
And is this the December box?
It's a December box, and it's Entrophy DK and Milk and Honey. So it's a merino alpaca and milk fiber.
Okay.
And I got Radium, which is so not my color. But it's okay. I could take it off of here. Actually, I can leave it on here. So, this is the color I got. And it's pretty greens, just not my greens, and I wouldn't wear this. And so, you can see it does have like a little fuzziness because that's from the alpaca. Mm-hmm. And I've been pulling out, I thought it was like my hair or cat hair in it already, and I'm like, there's no way. But it's brown hair, so it must be from a brown alpaca because I'm getting brown hairs out of it. Yeah. I thought that was kind of funny. But this is two skeins. Doubled. Mm-hmm. So it's 260 yards doubled.
So you wound them together.
Yeah, so technically back 260 yards. And I wound them together so that I can make a...
I guess it would be like a chunky.
Yeah, I did it as a bulky or a chunky.
Chunky, yeah.
I did bulky, I think.
Well, it depends on where you're from. Bulky and chunky are the same thing.
Yeah, I never understood that.
Yeah.
I know some people write bulky, some people write chunky.
What's the difference? When I was working at a yarn store, the wraps per inch and like the gauge and stuff for a chunky is what in the US and other places they call bulky.
Right.
And then our bulky is like what they call super bulky. So,
sorry, I'm trying not to cough.
So I think that's working up to like a chunky.
Yeah. So I like it. I mean, it's not
it's
for me.
Green.
So it's perfect. Yeah. It's going to work for someone else. It's a gift. Can you imagine
another
I'm
gift
making
gift.
A gift?
I know. I was shocked.
Seriously. So can I go in and show this now?
Yeah. So now we're into what?
Look at that. That was quick enabling this time. I don't have anything else. I can't believe that. I can't believe she has nothing. That's shocking.
Okay, after last time, though, like, if more had come in, really.
She has more coming in.
What do I have more? What do I have coming in?
Don't you have? Did you buy anything else for now?
I don't think so.
That you got? That you bought in December?
I don't think so. I signed.
Yes, you did the DVD.
Yes.
I'm sorry.
But that's gonna come in the new year.
Oh, okay.
So I ordered some.
Oh, then technically it's a new year purchase.
It's new year purchase. I ordered some Desert Vista Dyeworks for our cow, our sock cow, and then I also signed up for another Rosie's Moments box because her new themes come out and she's doing Natural Wonders of the World, and her January really box pretty. Is the Grand Canyon.
Oh, how cool! That'll be really nice.
But other than that, I haven't bought anything.
That'll be really nice.
Yes.
Very cool.
Yeah, mystery boxes don't count, so I don't count those as
no. And the fact that you purchased something now for January,
yeah,
technically counts as purchase this year, but it's like a freebie for January.
Yeah, when it's it comes perfect. In, like
yeah, it's a total freebie. Exactly, that's perfect. So, on to whips. So here you're gonna ask me the pattern name for this.
I was gonna say, do you know what the pattern is? Do you have it in your Ravelry yet?
Yes, I do.
Do you want me to look?
Yes. It's in my project page.
Okay. Well, you, so talk, if you go back you to talk project. About it, I'll look.
So it's a free pattern. I wanted something free because this was a gift knitting, and I didn't want to purchase a pattern for this. I didn't know if I was going to like it knit up. So look how pretty it's knitting up, though. You can totally see it. Like totally see that. And it's super long. I'm knitting it up on 9 millimeters because I didn't have 10 millimeters, and which is what, 13 US? I think it calls for 15 US. So yeah. That's all I got.
It's called Gallows.
That's right. Gallows Cowl was like a pirate thing with someone will know the reference. I don't know the reference.
Get a picture up here.
But someone knows the reference of it. And this is why I knit it, actually, based on this picture that she's going to show you right now. This is why I knit it. I think that's the, look at that. Can you see that? It's so pretty. Excuse me. I thought it was really pretty.
Yeah. I think it suits that.
And so nicely. The person that's going to is a redhead, and she's going to look stunning in this, or this is going to look stunning on her. Either way. It's going to be, both of them are going to be beautiful. I don't know how to ever word that. Do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah.
You tell someone that something looks good on them, but it's not that it looks good on them or they look good in it. You know what I mean? Like,
it just complements each other.
Right. Sometimes they're just both beautiful together.
There's
so.
Your resolution.
Yeah, back. Perfect. Okay. So that's it. That's all I'm working on,
that's
actually.
All you're
Can you believe
on. Okay.
that?
No, because often you're just working on one thing.
I know.
Usually you just work
on I'm waiting for the new year to start new projects, so I didn't want to really...
I don't have a lot of whips either.
I didn't want to start anything new, but I didn't really want to start anything too new.
No, okay, I can't say that I don't have a lot of whips, because I do have ones that I didn't bring because I haven't touched them.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm only working on two things.
That's okay.
Right now, yeah.
That's okay.
Yeah.
That's two. Hey, that's two. I got two because I got to still finish something for tomorrow.
Yes. That one's very little finished left, though.
Yeah. It's my sweater that I was going to wear today that I didn't wear today, but I had to pick up here, and I'm having issues picking up stitches because, you know, that's just the way I go.
So, guess who's...
Yeah, so she's going to just help me out to make sure. I was picking them up, and then I was going around, and I'm like, they're gapping. So I stretched it all back out, so it looks nice and neat now. Like, you can't even tell.
And she wants to finish that butt for her 2016 resolution.
Right,
so I need to
tomorrow.
I need to do that today.
Yeah. Before, all I need to do is pick them up for me. I can just do all
the
rest.
I'll try picking
But
them
it just made no sense the way it asked me to do it. And then I was picking it up, and I'm like, that still made no sense to me. So, yeah. So what whips do you have?
I have two whips that I've worked on. So Dennis's sweater is at home because after I showed you, I didn't touch it because I had other things to work on.
Right.
And then the other thing that's at home is the frost hat, because...
The one for Avery with the
pom-pom.
Yeah,
with the pom-pom, because I didn't touch that. It doesn't need to be done, so
no.
I didn't touch that. So.
And then you were working on... Oh.
Right.
I was about to ask about that.
Yeah. So update on the mother-in-law sweater. It's sitting on my lap, so...
It is. I was about to ask her, is that done? Because I knew she went to her mother-in-law's, and I knew she was, like, doing stuff with it.
So as you can imagine, it did not get finished. I think I could have finished it had I done nothing else.
But you could have done, though. You have
it was
to do this.
New Year, or not New Year's, it was Christmas Eve when I was working on it, and it was Christmas Day when I was working on it, and, like, we did family stuff, right? Like,
you have to.
Yeah,
you still
like,
have a child,
you know, we're
you
opening gifts, and, like, Dennis got a game, so I couldn't be like, oh, no, I don't want to play your game with you, I'm knitting, right? So, like, I would knit when I could, but
can't you multitask? Knit and play a game?
No,
I'm just bugging you.
I guess it depends on the
just
game.
Bugging you.
He got the game of life with the minions.
Oh, cool. That is
so
super cool.
There was lots of little pieces.
Is that automated now?
No, it's like,
okay,
it's
so
like cards.
Like the old...
It's cards and little people, but they're minions.
Very cool.
So yeah, we did that kind of stuff. So I'm like, you know what? I decided not to focus on it and try and get it done because we were doing other stuff. So my goal was to get the body done.
Yeah.
so that I could bring it and have her try it on. And I was like, well, at least this way I can make sure the length is good on her and the shoulders are good on her. And then because the sleeve stitches are on holders, I can measure her arms so that when I do finish it, which, like, I'm going to get back to it, like, right away, I can make the sleeves to her length.
Right.
Right? So I put it in a box and I put a tape measure in there. And then she opened it. She pulls out the tape measure. She's like,
what's this?
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, exactly. She was so nice about it. That's funny.
Because she would thank you for anything. If you put anything in a box, she'd be like, oh, thank you. I love it. I was like, that's not sweet. The gift. I just need to measure your arms. So anyway, this is
what
it.
What a good sport she is.
Yeah. She's like the nicest lady ever. All right, so I finished the body.
Look how pretty that is. Yeah.
Okay, so I'll pull it back here.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, there we go. Okay, here, so let me hold on to this with you. I finished the body. There we go.
Look how pretty. Am I holding other?
Yeah, I think so. So it's got the garter bottom and the sleeves are on holders. So I just have to put these on needles and knit 15 inches. That's what I measured, 15 inches.
Very nice. Yeah. It's nice and soft.
It is very soft. And at least this way I can block it too, because if I had finished it, I wouldn't have had time to block it. And it's a little, you know, how it is before you block it.
Is that how petite she is? Because that's kind of short.
It's how long the pattern said. She is petite, though. She is
like I've never seen her, so I didn't know. I only saw her on picture.
She's like 5'2 or 5'. Like, I'll have a chance to block it and make it look like nicer.
I see the gold now. I see that it's gold. Yeah. It is so pretty. I can't believe
I showed
that.
It last time. It's got the gold sparkle. And this is a Rowan brand yarn. It's Cash Soft or so, or Lux. I didn't bring the little thing. It was Lux something. It's in my project page. Yeah. I've linked it in my project page. It's a discontinued yarn, but it's super soft and super comfy, and I think she'll like it, and she'll be able to layer it and wear it with, like, all different... That's where my woven mines.
Oh, you do it right in the middle?
Well, that's where it was.
Oh, so I see, like, if I... Oh, because you're knitting this in the round. You can't.
No, I'm not, but it's just... The yarn was, like... It had weird things, and I was just like, you know what?
I only noticed it on the inside. Yeah. You can't see it on the outside.
You can't see it on the outside.
No, I only noticed. I was like, what's that on the inside? Very cool, though. It's really pretty. It's really nice and soft.
It is soft.
She's going to love that, wearing that. Every time she thinks of you when she wears this, going to be like,
she has other sweaters. I think I've knit her 2 other sweaters.
That's very nice. Very nice.
Next year, though, I'm going to try and put her in my sock rotation so that I don't have to worry about this, and she'll have socks for Christmas.
That'd be nice.
Yeah.
Will that be her first pair of socks?
Yeah, I haven't knit her socks.
That'll be really nice. Yeah. Just don't take me out of your rotation, please.
No, you'll still get a pair. Alright, so that's it.
Soon she's going to have to increase her numbers of socks she knits a year.
I know, I don't know how I'm going to do that. Sorry, I just dropped something. I don't know. I was thinking, because I was counting, and I was like, okay, I have my brothers, I have Tiffany, I have Rebecca, I have Dennis. His socks.
Yeah.
I want to put his mom in. And I was looking at how many that was going to be, and then I looked at my goal. I changed my goal some of my goals. I haven't told you yet. And I was like, okay, well, we'll just have to see what happens.
We'll see.
Yeah, we'll just see. You never know what's going to happen.
I get one pair. I'm happy with one pair.
You get one pair, for sure. And I'd like to make Rebecca another pair. But...
Yeah. I love my pair. Did I show everybody my pair?
She's wearing them today.
Yeah,
I can't. Look at my pair!
You can't see the front of them,
maybe
really.
I could, but I'm not going to try.
It's the bottom of them. Yeah. I love my socks. Yeah. Love them. Love them. Yeah. I love them. I do. I really love them. I love that it's Molly Girl yarn. I love the bling in it. I love that the... I have to say they're... Okay, so the other socks you made me, which were...
Cupcake yarn. This is a very
thinner yarn. This is more dense, it feels like. It's more squishier. I love it. I really do love it. And the pattern in Igneous...
Igneous,
Lisa Ross. Right? Yep. Yeah. Perfect. Love it.
I would do that pattern again.
Yeah.
So the problem is, though, I have, like, at least 5 or 6 or more skeins that I've kind of, in my mind, said, these would be perfect for Tiffany. Yes. And if I make her one a year, it's going to take me a long time to get through those skeins.
That's okay. You can make me 2 a year.
But I don't know if that's going to fit into my routine.
I know, but that's, I know.
We'll see. So do you have any more whips?
Nope, that's the only whip I have. Right. I'm not working on anything else. And
so I have one more.
My sweater.
And I didn't have any socks on the needles. I was telling you this last night. I have no socks on the needles. And I didn't want to cast on a new pair because we're doing our New Year's Day cast on for our cow.
That's right.
So what I decided to pull out, just so I'd have something kind of easy, was my cranky socks. And if you remember watching our summer episodes... when we did all our road trips.
Yes, this was your birthday road trip, wasn't it?
This was the birthday one where I think we went up to Port Elgin?
Docknitz and Port Elgin.
Yeah. So it was for my birthday, and we did part of our summer road trip. We went to like 5 or 6 stores in one day. It was so much fun. And in Docknitz and Port Elgin, they had this thing called Cranky Socks.
Look at that.
And when I first saw them, I was like, what did we make a sock monkey? Like, what is this?
I know, that's what I thought too.
What it is,
like, how cute.
Or what it was, is they made this big machine knit tube that you could then cut and section off and make socks from. So I was like, you know what, that's what I'm going to work on, because it's not a full pair of socks. Like, no. I'm not starting new socks.
Right. All you have to do is add heels, yeah. Toes, and cuff.
Yeah, and the tube I got was enough to make 2 pairs, and I decided I was going to make kind of coordinating socks for my brother and his girlfriend. So they would have the same body of the sock,
yeah,
but different heels and cuffs and all that. So I decided to start one of those. So I cut it in half, and so far I've got the toes on it.
Very cool.
So this yarn here was not knit by me. This was the machine knit tube.
Yeah.
And so pretty. This is how the tops were with the waist yarn, I guess. And so I cut them in half, and I have 2 other pieces like this at home. And then I added my toes.
Very nice.
So they each have
Is that stroll?
This is stroll. Yeah, this is knit-pick stroll in like a navy or something.
Very nice.
So I added the toes. And now I'm just working on the cuff of this one. And then I'll do the cuff of this one. And then I'll measure. I think this is the pair I'm going to do for his girlfriend.
Okay.
I just have to measure from the toe then her foot length.
Right.
And cut in a heel.
Very cool. And then so you're doing a true afterthought heel.
Yeah.
Wow, awesome.
And then Ian's pair will be the same as this, but I'm going to do gray heels, toes, and cuffs.
That'd be really nice.
Yeah.
Really nice.
I was hoping to get them done for Christmas as part of their Christmas socks, but I've decided to just...
Give them to Valentine's Day if you can get them done for then.
Well,
like,
they have 2 pairs each, so it's not like have no socks. But my other 2 brothers have 3 pairs. So 2 of my brothers are going to be getting 3 pairs of socks, and they're going to be getting 2 pairs of socks, but then I also got them other stuff that the other brothers aren't getting, so I was like, you know
what, okay. It all works out. Yeah. And if you and get these done sooner, then you can give them to them for like Valentine's Day or something. And
Can save them for their birthdays, or I can just put them, and then next year they get 3 pairs and my other brothers get 2 pairs or something.
Right.
I don't know. So I wasn't going to stress over it. I just thought this was a nice, leisurely knit. Like, it's still socks, but I didn't have to start a whole pair. And then, if I'll just keep working on them until the first when we start our cal, and then maybe put them aside or, you know, focus on the other ones. And then whenever I just need something in between, I can pull these out. So
like swimming socks or something like that or something, you know.
So these are my cranky socks.
That's
my stomach.
I'm sorry.
I know. I don't know why you don't eat before we do this. I made sure I had my lunch before I came over.
I know, but today I wasn't feeling well.
How about something? Had crackers.
I haven't eaten. Just one of those days.
Okay.
Okay.
So now what? Pulse?
Yeah.
Fish have this?
Diamonds are forever?
Diamonds are forever.
Yeah,
totally. Go first?
You want me to go first?
Yeah, you go first.
Okay. So last week I totally, totally forgot to bring this. I can't believe I did. I don't know how I did that. But
it's okay. We had so much to talk about last time.
I finished.
Yeah. And did you finish this like right after the time before when you said you were going to do it before your road trip?
Yeah, this was like the end of November, beginning of December. I finished those.
Yeah.
I know. I can't believe I didn't show it. I'm so sorry. I forgot it, but it turned out beautiful. So this is my knit night. This is the bottom. That's the top.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Your tummy is...
I know, I'm starved. I don't know if I'm starved.
Well, they say you're hangry.
Hangry. Well, I'm not angry. Look how pretty this is. So, I don't know if you can see the beads. See the beads on there? So, there's an eyelet right in there. Oh, you can kind of see the eyelet. Right in there, there's beads. And on the top here, there's beads. Of course, I have to show you a peach section. Let's show you something darker so you can see it.
You're so anti-peach.
Well, no, it's just so you can see it more. So, it was really light. See? And then the eyelets has beads right in here.
Yeah.
So, it's really pretty.
And on the bottom.
And on the bottom, there's a pico edging, too, with the beads.
With beads.
And, I didn't, of course, you know me.
I added this pattern again to my list for next year.
And I really enjoyed knitting it, I have to say.
I think if you have a skein of fingering yarn, and you're not quite sure what to do with it, but you want some sort of neck accessory.
Yeah.
This is a really good pattern, because you can use the whole skein, and because it's so long and shallow, it's really easy to wear.
Well, you could block it a bit, make it a little bit wider.
You don't have to.
You don't have to.
You just wrap it around and have your tails, and it's really, really easy to wear.
What I liked was if I could
Or you could do this too, yeah.
Yeah, I could double it and just wear it like this. And then that was fine. And it still has a little bit of length. And you see the beading. And I love the colors. Like, it's just, can't go wrong with this.
I really like this pattern. And it was fun to knit too because it was so repetitive.
And the funny thing was when I saw this at that yarn shop that we went to. And that, again, this was a purchase from...
our yarn crawl over the summer.
Yeah, and she had this knit up with the exact same yarn. Yeah. And I was like, oh my God, I don't know about that peach, because then she showed me the yarn, like too much peach. But when I saw it knit up, I was like, you barely even noticed the peach in here. And it's just so pretty. And it's all spread out. I'm really happy with it, like really happy with it. It wasn't too long of a knit. The beads took a little bit longer to do. But if you did it without beads, you can do it faster. She did it without beads.
And I did it, I used a lot more yarn for mine. Mine turned out, I think, bigger.
I know.
And it was still, like, I didn't get bored of it, because even though it was repetitive, like, it was something that was just so easy to pick up. Like, those nights where I'm like, oh, I don't want to sit here and do nothing, but I really don't want to concentrate on anything. It was very easy to pick up.
It's kind of a mindless knit.
Yeah.
This is the Manon de Argue. Totally mindless. And an Allegria, and I love it. It's squishy. Yeah. I really like it. I would do this again. I would probably still do it with beads again, even though that took me a little bit longer.
I did add it to my queue for 2017, and I think I know which yarn I want to use, but I don't know if I'll do beads. I liked that mindless aspect of it, that I didn't have to worry about the beads. I could just pick it up and do one row if I wanted to.
No, that's true.
So I don't know.
I just like the beads, so I thought it added a little bit of...
And weight too, it adds a bit of weight.
It adds a little bit of weight, but it just added a little bit of more bling to it. I didn't have sparkly yarn or anything like that. But it was just pretty. I really liked it. It was a fun knit. Totally. If you haven't knit this yet, definitely add this to your queue. It's a great knit for yourself or for a gift.
Yeah, definitely for a gift it's good, because I think a lot of people could wear it.
Yeah. That's my one. Do you want to do one? How many do you have?
I have one.
You only have one?
I think so.
You only have one FO? I beat you again in FOs?
Yeah.
Shocker. That's a shocker.
Oh, I should have brought another one just so you didn't beat me. I finished a washcloth
for
my mom. Nice. And I was like, I won't bring a washcloth. This is just a washcloth.
Oh, I know.
And then
that's an FO.
That's an FO, I know. And now you beat me.
Beat her.
I'll live.
For that's your end.
Yeah.
Hey, see, I should do that. I should try to do that. Yeah.
I think, though, if we add it up over the year.
Oh, God. Erin beats me in total projects altogether. Yeah. Like,
we were just looking before we started recording about how many projects, like, because you tag your projects, right?
I do.
Yeah, so in our Ravelry project page, we tag all our projects with that year, so that there's, like, a tab at the top of the page, and then you can click on that, and it shows you everything you've done. So we were looking at, you know, what she's done and what I've done over the year, so.
We'll talk about that later.
Yeah, we'll talk about that when we do our, after we show everything, we're going to go into our resolutions recap and future planning.
Yeah. Okay. So go ahead, because I need to borrow anything else.
Okay. Well, yeah, I only brought one. Okay. So I finished husband socks.
Look how nice they are.
Do I have a tag?
Excuse me. So these were the ones for Christmas.
We moved everything, and now I don't know where I brought the tag. It might be in the bag. Anyway, husband socks. So we were talking about these last time. And I was going to try and get these done for Christmas.
Christmas. But when were they done? Because I know you're working on your mother-in-law's sweater. So
I brought them to her house to work on, so I finished them Tuesday.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I basically at her house got to where I was going to be doing the toe, and then I just brought them home and finished the toe. So Tuesday. So look at the pretty colors.
They do. They look amazing.
I'm surprised he didn't find these, because the other day he's like, are my socks done? I want to wear them. And I was like, you can't wear them. I have to show them on the podcast before you get them all stanky. He's like, but I want to wear them. They're my socks. So he did not find them. So that's the other one. Fish lips kiss heel.
So why did you do a fish lips kiss heel for him? Because he did top down.
Because this was top down.
Okay.
And I don't really like doing the flap and the gusset and all that. And I don't do them often enough that it's something I just know how to do. I'd have to look it up and all that. Whereas the fish lips kiss I've done before, and it fits well enough. I did the where you add the stitches. I added 4 stitches before I started the heel.
Oh, okay.
So that it would be a bit deeper. And it fit them okay. So it's just, I think it's a 70 stitch plain vanilla.
Very nice.
Fish lips kiss heel, regular old grafted toe. I tried something new with the toes though. You know how I've complained.
There's a good word for you. It's the like word for today.
It's like Avery with all her verb tenses. Hey,
that's like my word for her.
She's like, I burped it. So yes, I'm a 5-year-old. I complained about how with the grafting of the toes,
right,
you get the little ears.
Yeah.
And I found a video on YouTube where it minimizes that a little bit.
Oh, nice.
The couch is black or brown, so you can't really see. I don't know if you can see.
It's rounded. It's a rounded toe. Okay, if you do it that fast, no one's going
to
see
it. I'm trying to find a good spot where it's not on the brown couch. But you can kind of see the ears.
See rounded toe.
Yeah, it's not rounded. It's just, it doesn't have those little...
pointiness.
Those little
Yeah, but it's a little bit ears. More rounded, though, yeah. in there.
Because it doesn't have those yeah. little ears. So if I can remember, I'll try and link to that video.
Okay.
Because it was very simple, but it just made it so that... Because that's what always frustrated me with grafting. Like, remember I did a grafted heel. And I was getting... Yeah, frustrated because it was have these little points. Weird,
yeah.
And this minimized it.
That's good.
So
I like it.
I'll do that again. So I'll try and link the video.
I like it. I like it a lot.
So I'm going to try another heel that's grafted or Kitchenered at the end.
Okay.
With this technique to see if it helps.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Very cool. Very cool.
Yeah. Oh, and this, I had a little bit of this left over. Remember I did the toes? Brown toes. See, we moved everything around and now I don't know where things are. When we first sat down to do this, she sat on this side and I sat on that side, and we had everything set up, and then we're like,
we gotta switch.
Oh darn, we're on the wrong side. Yeah. Yeah, so now I don't know. Anyway, I did the brown toes because I didn't know if I'd have enough to do the sock because I did such a long leg,
right?
And I had about 20 grams left, so I would have been fine. Oh, but good. I like the brown toes.
I like the contrast in there. I think next year, when I do make some socks...
Oh, here it is.
That's
what I have left over. Oh. But I don't know where the tag is. The tag might be under my... I don't know. Oh, here it is.
There it is. I won't say what that is.
So this is the yarn I used for his socks. And I don't think I've ever said the color because it's just...
A number?
Numbers. Let me see that. Let's see. I don't know if it's going to focus. But one of those numbers is the color.
Yeah.
Yeah. But see this.
It was really nice though. The color was really nice, like the men's color. Yeah. I liked it a lot.
I'd like to go back there if we go up to Barrie again. I'd like to go.
Oh, you know, there is another this year. They're gonna have another yarn crawl. Yeah.
What do they call the lakeside
yarn crawl.
Yeah.
I hope they take a couple shops this year that totally should not be on it.
Or even just add one. Some new ones. I'm sure.
Or exactly some add some yeah. new ones. And there's also a yarn crawl out in the East End.
Yep. Yeah.
That Pokeroo told us about.
Yeah, we might do that one too.
And that one I think starts earlier, like March.
Okay, well then we can do all of them.
Let's just do them all. You know, because the more the merrier. It doesn't count as stash because
we're gonna try and not buy online this year.
Right.
Because we were thinking about it, it's like every time you buy online, even if you're lucky enough to even get the cheaper shipping, which is like $10, and sometimes it can go up to $20. Over the course of the year, that's a lot of skeins of yarn just in shipping. Just yeah. in shipping. So we are going to try and really not buy
and
online.
And I pay Canadian dollars. So it's 30% on top of it for shipping and for the yarn.
Yeah. So we're going to try and buy.
It's so expensive.
From local stores.
Local stores or when I travel. Because now I know when I travel, someone will be giving me a list. Yeah. Festivals. Yeah. And yarn crawls, like stuff like that. So if we do trips like that, so that's where most of our purchases will come from this year.
We'll look up that. We're going to look into that yarn crawl.
Definitely going to try not to buy anymore, so I better buy everything between now and tomorrow.
That's what I've been doing.
I know she has.
I've totally stocked up. I don't have to. I have more than enough yarn. I wouldn't have to leave the house and I'd have enough yarn for the next year.
I know. I have more than enough yarn that can last me probably
three years. Yeah. I think I have about a 3 year. I was trying to look at my stash. I'm like, okay. If something happened and I couldn't buy any yarn, I think I have enough yarn for 3 years worth of projects.
Oh, I definitely have enough yarn for 3 years worth of projects. My problem is that what I have, like if it's mostly fingering, let's say, compared to my worsted, I don't really have bulky or Aran weights.
I know, but you would just have to work with what you have.
I have a couple worsted, but most of my stuff is fingering.
Yeah. So you just
have one skeins, like one skeins.
Yeah.
I'm like, what do you do with
you
one
skein? You double two fingering skeins to get a worsted, and then you have 400 yards.
Well, I know, but I'm saying like that. There'll always be small projects. I wouldn't have stuff to make too many medium to larger projects.
You just have to be inventive if you really had to.
So, there's a couple skeins of yarn that I might have to buy because I haven't stopped talking about one of them.
Yes, okay, one of them. She has been talking about for like months.
Yeah, this was before my birthday or just before your birthday.
And she kept saying, no, it's shipping and the exchange. I'm like, Tiffany, you have not shut up about this yarn for weeks and weeks. Just buy the yarn. Just buy it.
Just buy it. Yeah. The other day, she's like, you got to buy it.
Just buy it.
And I still haven't bought it. Yeah. And I still talk about it. And it's in my head. And I still want it. And I even messaged the lady. are you going to have any Boxing Day sales on?
She's just like, buy it.
Buy it now. So I got to buy it now so it doesn't count for the new year.
Yeah, it doesn't count. Yeah.
And there's only one more thing that I might purchase. Might. Only because she's come out with some great colorways.
Okay.
That I could totally add to my stash, and then I don't need any really more.
Well, we can talk about this in resolutions, because we'll I have plans for purchasing.
Okay.
So you finished something else.
I did. Okay. I'm so excited. So, Gail, you should take a look at these, because I loved knitting them.
You wanted the foot.
Oh, yeah. I wanted the
foot. Here, give me a sock.
You can put this one on there, because So, yeah, it's socks. I finished socks. So, Gail, I'm very happy with them. I love your sock blanks. Like, love them. If you've not purchased Gail's Art Socks Blanks, go buy them, because they are so nice to knit up with. Her yarn is just beautiful, and I don't really get, you know, people were saying, like, they get a lot of waviness, and I don't really have
that. Not the finished sock. I didn't find that in my finished sock either.
Yeah, I don't find I have that in the finished sock. Now, this is a Scatterbee. See, I remember that. This is a Scatterbee pattern. Look at that. Look how beautiful my sock came out.
To make any socks that I make for you to fit this form, because this sock...
That's a tighter one. This is a better one.
This sock perfectly fits this form.
Excuse me. That's a tighter one. Mm-hmm. So this was 60-something stitches. This is 72 stitches. And this fits perfectly.
That's like, a big difference. How did you manage that?
I just did different ones. I just wanted to see the difference between them.
Okay, so 64 stitches.
That's a little tight on me.
Okay.
No, 68, I think. That one is 68. 68. Maybe.
Okay, because 64 to 70 something.
No, I think that's a 68, and this is a 72.
Okay.
I did the flegel heel. Yeah. I love it. Looks a little weird. There we go. Let's put it this way. I love the flegel heel. I really do. And you can tell, see, if you turn this sock around. Okay, let's do it this way. You can tell they kind of match.
They're a pair.
You know what I mean? They have the same coloring and everything.
Fraternal. What do they say? Fraternal twins.
If you do the back of it, turn the back, you can totally see, like, it's funny how the yellow, that orangey comes in the heel and stuff. Like, yeah, you can totally see it. I love them. I love them.
Okay, do you have a favorite child?
Do I have a favorite child?
Yeah.
Oh, like, which one I like better? This one.
Is there one that you like better?
I like this one because it's bigger. The color-wise on the back is more of my favorite, which is funny, because this one doesn't, so the color in the front has more pink on that one, though, so I like that. But this one fits better.
Okay.
So, but with the pattern, maybe it's because of the pattern in here is why I need a 72, and if it's perfect, because it probably cinches in a bit. Mm-hmm. But I tried it on, and the heel fits perfectly. Love the flegel heel, I think. So, I just have to bring this up, because 2016, one of my resolutions was trying to find a sock pattern that fits me.
Okay.
And I think I finally found the length of what my foot needs to be, and the heel. So, I think I really do like the flegel heel, and the length is good. The only thing that I'm still working on is stitches.
Your toes or your stitch count?
The stitch count.
Figuring out your stitch count.
That is a little tight on me, but it's not like uncomfortable. 68.
Okay.
And this is a 72.
So why don't you try 70?
So there's nothing really, I mean.
Although, but they fit
now. The yarn makes a difference too. Difference.
It does make a difference. But people also say that your socks stretch out. So over wear, this might be a good experiment, because you might find wearing these over the next couple months.
This one maybe.
This one ends up being a better fit, and this one gets too loose.
Exactly.
And then you know.
Yeah. And I can tell the difference of them because the toe's different on which one, so I know which one's different. But so I'm so happy. So I finished them. I finished a pair of socks from you. This is a psychedelic flower from Gail's Arts. Yes, and see, Jeanette, just to show you, Erin did my toes for me. So this just needs to be sniffed off.
Because I weave them in like right after I get past the first couple.
Yeah, she did my toes for me because she does them so tight. She knits super tight. She tells me she doesn't.
I don't know.
I can barely fit my needles get my needles into knit the rest of the toes and going
up. I knit socks tight because super I like a dense fabric. But my other projects that I knit, like sweaters and garments and accessories and stuff, I do not knit tight.
Yeah, but no. Your socks are super tight compared to what I knit.
I like a dense sock.
I knit tight, though.
That's why I've gone down to 2 millimeter.
I know, but I'm on 2 millimeter, and I thought I knit super tight. Sometimes I feel like I'm going to break the yarn because I'm like pulling it so tight.
You have to ease it on.
Oh, God. Okay. There we go.
There.
That just fits just as well, though. So this is a bigger sock. I just wanted to see
the
difference.
What I'm saying. If I make a sock, you are not around to try it on. If I try it on this form and it fits well, it should fit you.
Yeah.
Because it like perfectly fits this foot.
And you can see exactly where the heel and everything. Yeah. Yeah. So it does. But you can see this one's not as tight on here.
I can't see the difference.
Yeah, I love it. Yeah. And then you could tell how small
it is. See, I should have brought my other foot, and then we could put them both on our foot.
Yeah, that's too funny. I do have, like, sock thingy somewhere. I just don't know where they are.
Blockers?
Right now.
You have blockers, though.
The metal ones.
Yeah, you don't. You don't have like a.
No, foot. I have a forearm.
You don't have a decapitated foot.
Yeah, kind of a freaky foot. Yeah. So yeah, so that's it. So I really like these. I'm really happy with them. They fit here. Okay, this was a big thing for me. They fit here perfectly, like perfectly, because I think of the increases in the flea mm-hmm. heel. They fit perfectly. Mm-hmm. And they fit my arch, mm-hmm. and they grip back here, I think, mm-hmm. enough too. And I didn't do an inch increase. I went right into the pattern.
Yeah, with Fleetwood, so, you don't have to do that.
Yeah, love them. I love them. I'm happy with them. I got a pair of finished socks. I told Gail that these were going to be done this year, and I was right.
She just
and I did them.
We did.
Oh no, these were done like if this was done beginning of this week.
Okay, but still, it's the end of December. Oh,
yeah, but because this was not a focus. This was like a project saying, here and there.
You got the sock blank when, and you told her it'd be done by the end of the year.
I got it in May. I told her it started probably September, which I started August. And then September, October, November, we had Cal's going on. So this was something that I was going to finish in December once I did all my other December projects.
But this is like the last week of December, so you just got in there.
It's okay.
It's like you were working on them that morning. Yeah, you
still done. That's right. It's still done.
Right.
I love them. So that's it. That's all I got. That's it. So
I'm just going to adjust because I'm sinking into this squishy couch.
That's okay. I know. It's awesome.
Okay.
So I think that's it. Is that all we have?
That's all we have for projects. So I have a little bit of diamond cutting.
Yes.
And then what we're going to go into is we're going to talk about our resolutions. So we talked about them in June.
Right.
Just to give an update of where we were with our goals. And now we're going to talk about what we accomplished.
What we accomplished.
Did we meet our goals? Yes. What would we change? And then also what we're planning for 2017 going into 2017. Right. So I will talk about my spinning. So on the last episode, I showed you two bobbins. And I was saying how I was hoping to have them spun up. Plied. For this episode.
Because you had them spun.
I had them spun and I wanted to have them plied. And I did finish it. So this is my natural merino.
That's nice and fluffy.
Yeah, it is. To ply. Neither of these have had their bath yet. So this is just right off the bobbin.
That's okay.
Should I do the thing where people do where they're like, oh, look how well my yarn is balanced. These are not going to be perfect, but they're okay. They're actually supposed to have a little bit of twist. See, just a little bit.
Just a little. Yeah.
Yeah, because once you wash it, I'm not going to do that.
I know. I was going to say, you don't want
to. And then my other one. So I remembered to bring the tag this time. So this is my Northbound Knitting Fiber. Right. And it was gray merino, because remember I said how it was a colored merino?
Oh, that's right.
So it's gray merino and silk. 70% gray merino, 30% silk. 4 ounces, and I had two of these, so this was 8 ounces. And I did a thicker single, and my goal was to chain ply it to get like a really bulky, like finished yarn, so that I could make some...
It's stunning. Is it stunning.
This is fat yarn. So that's stunning. This is my finished yarn for that.
I love it. Yeah. Look at the colors.
Like, can you see how thick?
Hey, look at it. I did it. Look how pretty that I turned it. Sure. Sorry.
Anyway, like, can you see how thick that is? It's so thick.
That is stunning.
Yeah, I keep covering you up. Sorry.
That's okay.
Yeah, so all those colors. And I actually like how it plied up. I like the colors.
It's beautiful. It's a lot of barbacoa.
Colors. No, well, because I chain plied it. Nice. So all the colors.
See, that I like.
I know. You like chain plied.
Yeah.
But like the colors when it was in the fiber, they were okay. I like them. And when I was spinning it, I was like, okay, it's a little pastel-y for me, but it's all right. But then when I plied them, I really like it.
Oh my God.
And my gorgeous. Goal, cause you know how I got my gray, the gray coat.
Yes.
I want to
yes.
make some mittens.
Yeah. So we were supposed to buy gray coats this year. That was something on our to-do list that we both wanted was a gray coat. So I emailed her saying, hey, this place is having a sale. Go check it out.
This was like September or October.
I didn't know she bought a coat. She didn't even tell me.
Okay.
Then she shows up here with a coat one day and I'm like, wait, why did you buy that?
She emailed me.
She's like, the email you sent me, how can I go wrong?
She sent me the email, and she's like, hey, look at this, maybe they have a coat. And I looked, and I found one that I was like, oh, that might work. So I messaged her, and I was like, because I thought maybe you'd want to go in together, that's why you sent me the link. So I was like, hey, did you see a coat you liked? And I didn't hear anything, so I was like, okay, so I just ordered it.
Oh, did I even get that message from you?
But I messaged you back. Oh. I asked you if you saw anything. And you didn't reply.
This is really pretty.
But I did find a great coat. So, yeah, so I'm thinking perfect. Of making mitts for my great coat.
How much yards do you know what you have here?
It's about 150 yards. Wow. Oh, and this one is about 100 yards. So I still have to do more of this for my blanket, my owl blanket. I still have to do more. But I'm going to try and mix it in with colored stuff so that I don't like want to like go crazy. Mm. But I'm happy with this.
I really love this. Yep. You should be happy with it. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's big. It's really nice.
Yeah, I like it.
Really, really nice.
It's not totally even, but I don't care.
Who cares?
Okay.
And you're going to make something for you. That's the best part about it. Yeah. And you completed your spinning goal for this year.
I did.
Because technically...
I ended up with about 62 ounces. And nice. My goal was 60 ounces.
That's right. That's amazing.
Yep.
That's amazing. Good for you.
Yep.
You.
So, should
you
we...
want to go into that?
Should we talk just teeny, teeny bit about the cow?
Sure, we could do that now.
Okay. Because I got one. So, we talked last time how we're starting a new cow for January. And it's going to be stripy socks.
That's right.
And we're stripy sock yarn. You don't have to make socks. And we're teaming up with Sadie from Yarnivore Podcast.
Yeah, Knitter's Nightmares.
Knitter's Nightmare. And she is doing stripy socks.
She's doing stripy socks, yes.
But we are just doing where you have to do a project using at least 50 grams mm-hmm. of sock weight, so fingering weight, striping sock yarn. Yeah. And I linked in the thread four dyers
yeah.
that if you use their yarn.
So it's Fibernymph,
yeah.
Which is Lisa. And there is Susan, which is Desert Vista Dyeworks. And Laura from Jinx Yarns and Sadie from Knitter's Nightmare.
Yep. If you use their yarns, then you can get extra empties.
Extra bonus points,
yeah. So I wound my yarn. I am all ready to go for New Year's Day because it starts New Year's Day. So
love
this
it.
Is Fibernymph in Seven Deadly Sins.
Honestly, it's gorgeous and wound up. Like,
yeah, look
I
at
couldn't
that.
Believe it when I saw that today.
As I was winding, I was like, oh, I love that turquoise. Oh, I love that pink. Oh my God, look at that orange. Oh, look at that
I
green.
I know.
Love it. All my colors. All my favorite colors.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway. So it's in my yarn.
Even the green?
No, I like that green. I don't mind red, but red's not my favorite. But together, no, I like it together.
But it's not a real red.
It's an orangey red.
Yeah, and that's yep. what makes a difference, I think.
Yep. So it is in my yarnet, all ready to go for my mom's house.
And her purple yarnet.
Yeah, my purple yarnet. Yeah. I have to find the little plug, though, so I can lock it.
You don't have one?
I have one, I just don't
know.
Oh,
okay.
So it's all ready to go. It's probably in a project bag somewhere. And nice. What's the first nice. One you're casting on?
Desert Vista Dyeworks.
Okay.
100%.
And the superhero one, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love it. And okay. I can't wait to knit that up. And
get my towel.
Actually, I saw someone knit it up.
And
yeah, there was a post I was looking at and someone had it knit up. I was looking to see what I can do with self-striping besides socks.
Yeah.
Those I'm definitely doing in socks, but it's a Jinx yarn that...
You're not sure you might do
I'm
something
I'm not sure. I don't know yet. So I was trying to see what other people did and then I saw those socks knit up in that color and I was like, oh, interesting. I didn't know that's how it was going to look. Excuse me. Because... You know, a skein looks different than when it's knit.
You know what, the thread that we have, so we don't have like a no chatter for FO, I just keep track of things.
Mm-hmm.
If you've done a project using self-striping yarn, self-striping sock yarn that's not socks, you should post a link to it in the thread.
Definitely.
In case other people are looking.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like give some ideas.
I know there's a hat. I had a hat in my favorites that uses self-striping and it makes it kind of look like a checker.
Oh, neat.
So something like that, like where it's not socks, but it benefits from using self-striping.
We'll see with this one here. I was even thinking like a scarf because mm-hmm. something or a shawl that might like a crescent shawl mm-hmm. if I could find one that would work with self-striping mm-hmm. because it's, to me that's something where I think the Jinx yarn is where I'd want to wear it like yeah. hands, neck, or head.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Maybe hat. I think if you get into shawls you're going to start breaking up the stripes and it's not going to look like stripes anymore.
True. But if I do a hat then...
Or, oh, you know, okay, I don't know if this would be your style. Josh Ricks has a shawl that I really, really, really want to make that uses self-striping.
I like his
and
design.
He does short rows, so you do.
Yes,
the stripes go like this, and then you use it with a complementary solid.
Oh.
I forget what it's called. It's in my favorites. Okay. Maybe when you're talking about your resolutions, I'll look it up.
Okay.
But that would be a really cool thing to use your striping.
I like really his, cool. okay. his patterns.
Chatter.
He has really nice patterns. That. I'm chattering. Okay, so. Anyways, you need to do something with self-striping yarn. So if you do... you could use other self-striping yarn, indie dyers, or self-striping yarn in general. It doesn't have to be Desert Vista Dyeworks, Jinx Yarns, Knitter's Nightmare, and Fibernymph. It could be anything else. It's totally up to you.
You just get extra entries.
You get extra entries for if you do use those. And I'm sure everybody has those in their stash.
Yeah.
And you know what?
Not everybody, but a lot of people do, actually.
Yeah, well, I'm sure someone has at least
people
one of them or
something.
People have been
posting in the thread already what they're going to use.
And if you do Desert Vista Dyeworks, totally, you're in it for hers because she does her program where you'd have to do a project
That's
every month.
Typhoon.
So you would have
this shawl.
Your socks at least knit for her January, you know, program, and that'd be awesome. I'd love to join hers. I just cannot knit a pair of socks every month for the whole year. Just not yet. But
yeah,
just not
I can't commit to that. I probably could if that's all I did, but I can't commit to
yeah,
it.
Yeah, it's something I can't do right now.
Figure out which is a good
picture. I don't make enough. I don't have enough knitting time to do that. And then be like, that's all I work on.
Yeah.
Not that socks take me a long time, but they do in a way because they're smaller needles. That is pretty.
Yeah.
That is really pretty. I love his designs.
He's
such a cutie too.
He is.
See,
I'm trying to find a picture where it shows the
colors of it.
The stripes, like how the stripes work.
So, definitely join that. You'll see the thread will be in the group, and join it for January. It'll be so much fun.
So this is the one I was just talking about. It's called Typhoon. And so you can see where the stripes are. It's done in narrower sections. So you can really see the stripes. And then there's a solid complementary. So you could totally do that with the Jinx one.
Yeah, then I just have to find a solid complementary,
yeah, which is fine. But I find it what's best is, like, if you have, let's say your Jinx is, like, blue, gray, blue.
And it is.
Don't pick a blue, a gray, or a blue as your solid, because then it blends right into it. You want to pick something that, like, contrasts.
I have the pink.
You could totally do a pink. Yeah,
I have the pink, and that's going to be perfect.
I might have to
mine's put
this
too.
I might have to put this back in my queue. Actually, I might still have this in my queue for next year.
Typhoon,
because I want to.
Mine is blue grays, and it has the bling in it.
Yeah,
and I have the pink that's left over from that cascade pink that I used for
your North Bend.
My North Bending one.
Yeah, your Lisa
much one cap. Yeah, that'd be perfect.
Totally do that. I might have to do one of those two. Okay,
that's what I was thinking.
It's a 2-month cow, so if I get two pairs of socks done, I might try and do a typhoon too.
Okay, I was only trying to get two projects.
Well, then why don't you do a pair? Yeah, so do a pair of socks.
Pair of socks. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah,
I just wanted something different for the Jinx yarn.
I think that's what you should do.
I love Lisa's yarn Susan's yarns. Defensive as Eye Works. I love my socks that I already have from her. That's why I can't wait to knit these socks again. But Laura's yarn, the Jinx yarn, is just, I don't know, it's different. It's prettier. I just want, not that it's prettier than Susan's, because it's not.
No, but they're all just like.
There's a difference there for me. I just want it to be closer to here. And Susan's, I want to show off on my feet. Like, I want them to be socks on my feet. I know, I can't.
Well, and also it's because it's like the, you love it that it's a superhero yarn.
Oh, yeah.
But it's got the red in it, and you don't tend to wear red near your face.
True.
Whereas Laura's is blues and grays, which you do tend to wear near your face. So that's more, I think, why.
Oh, I'm so excited. Thanks for showing me that.
You're
welcome. I was looking for stuff, and that's what I was doing the other day.
Anybody else who wants to join in and do a typhoon?
Oh my god, that'd be super cool.
Totally
I love, and Josh has amazing patterns.
He does.
He has other ones that I want to do too. Yeah, definitely. Cool.
Okay. So are we ready to talk about 2016?
Are we ready for
I think so. I've got mine ready.
Resolutions?
Yeah,
excellent.
I've got mine ready.
I will have mine ready in a second.
Okay. So we're going to talk about what our goals were that we made. These are the goals we made in 2015 that we wanted to accomplish this year.
Yes.
And how we did.
Okay,
and we'll try and keep it not too
excuse me
elaborate, so that because we want to do the 2000 our goals for 2017.
Okay,
so how are we gonna do this? You go through yours, or do we want to go back and forth, or what?
Yours were a little set up differently than mine.
Yeah,
mine were very specific.
Yeah, mine were more vague.
Yeah.
So okay, I'm just
which I learned
first.
From.
First, I'm just gonna say, guys, this was the first time you've done it.
Yes.
And this is my third year, and I'm getting better every year at making goals that I can accomplish. So in the Bling Your String group, every year I have a Crafty Resolutions challenge, and it's a year-round challenge. And what you do is you pick 12 resolutions. They just have to be crafty, not specifically knitting or crochet, anything crafty. And you make your 12 goals up to 12. You don't even have to do 12. If you only want to do 3, do 3. But you can do up to 12. And then over the year, you try and achieve those. Mm-hmm. And every time you achieve one, you get entered into a monthly draw. And then at the end of the year, I draw from the finishers again for a kind of a grand prize. So it's just a way to kind of focus your crafting and stuff like that. So that over the year, you just have something to draw on. If you're like, oh, I don't know what to do. What did I want to accomplish this year?
That's right.
So she joined for the first time this year. I think this is my third year.
And I learned. It's wording.
I'm learning.
Make sure you word your stuff correctly.
To give yourself flexibility.
Because I failed. I can't believe it. By one thing.
Yeah.
And it kicked me in the butt.
It was all just because of her wording.
And it was just of my wording. Because if I would have not said one every month, and I would have just had...
Over the year
or within the 12 months or something.
Yeah.
Or exactly. I would have totally reached all my goals.
Yeah.
I was so mad. Just the one. Yeah. Just the one. Excuse me. So... we both had on ours, learn how to double knit. That was something we wanted to do this year. We wanted to learn how to double knit.
And you
so
finished a project.
That was an actually extra thing too. Yeah.
I did not finish mine, but I still counted that done because I learned how to do it.
Well, no, learning how to knit was one of my things, but then learning how to double knit was one of my things. Knitting the double knit dragon scarf was another one.
Yeah.
So I did complete both of those. Yeah. I was very proud of myself. Excuse me. I'm so sorry. So where I failed was I tried to have one completed project every month for the 12 months, and I got 11 out of 12.
Yeah.
I almost had it.
But she completed more than 12 projects. So if she had just said,
right,
I want to complete 12 projects over the year,
right,
she would have been fine.
And I would have finished it, but my it was end of September, and right, I was in course.
Yeah.
And being in course for like a week and a half,
yeah,
killed me because I don't get knitting time. I'm at courses from like crack of dawn till nighttime. Actually, it's not even nighttime. It's like in the morning sometimes. And I don't have the time. Then I got to sleep for like the 5 hours and I'm back up again doing it.
That's where you fell behind.
So that's where I fell behind. My bad.
Yeah. But you know now.
Mm-hmm.
And you had a chance. She had it because in June I allow people to switch up to three in case things have changed. And she had that chance and she didn't want to.
Because I was very determined to do it. I see that something comes up like that where life just changes on you. And that's what made me, I couldn't complete it. Which is okay.
Yeah.
It's okay. Yeah, I learned my lesson. Everything else was completed except for that.
Right, so go on your next one.
So find a sock pattern or formula that fits me perfectly. I found the Flegel heel that fits. There's no typical like sock pattern because I want to try something.
But it's more
new.
Formula, and I think you pretty much got you're very close to that formula.
I'm very close between the 68 to 72 stitch based on these, because of the fact that depending on the yarn makes a difference in the stitch count.
You have to adjust it if it's a thinner yarn.
So that's worth something I've learned too. So that I did.
Yeah.
I actually wrote I almost have it, but I have it now.
I think you'd have it, yeah.
Now I have it.
You figured out the Flegel heel.
I love the Flegel heel. It works for me. In stall striping yarns, though, I'm still going to have to do an afterthought heel, though, because I just like that look. Yeah. Unless I do a
but
solid
toe or heel.
But
those ones I made you last year were self-striping, and I did a Flegel. It just makes them a little narrower.
No, it's not about the narrowness. It's about how the color flows through.
I know, but I did those
ones. Oh, because it was narrow striping.
It just narrows it a little bit, and it makes it, you know, you just have, and you can cut your yarn and make it start over again, like a bright spot, if you like that
fit. Or I could do a colored heel and toe or something, or just a colored heel if I wanted to.
It's harder with the Flegel because you start your increases down here.
No, but if I was going to do an afterthought heel or something,
afterthought,
I could just do
a colored
heel and make it so much easier.
Yeah.
So my stitch strip for socks were completed this year at the beginning of the year. Excuse me. My zigzag scarf was completed at the beginning of this year. My completed of my blue socks. My blue socks were done at the beginning of this year as well. And add all my yarn to Ravelry.
Yep.
That was done, except for my new purchases I just did.
But that won't take very long.
That we showed, last week?
Yeah.
So
because she's kept up with it, that won't take long.
Yeah, no. It's just that last week I got to put in. So that will be done between the next, by the end of the year. And put all my yarn cubbies together and store my yarn in them.
I did that.
That's all done. And what else did I have? Knit as much from stash as I can. So I have as much as I could. I did buy some new stuff and knit from it. Or I got yarn bucks and I knit from that. And then pretty much just to knit more. And I have been. Because obviously it proved to me that I finished a total of 19 projects this year.
We looked at our page.
19 projects. Where last year it was 10.
11, I think.
Was it 11?
10 or 11.
I don't remember.
Yeah, so she's done more.
19.
Yeah.
That's nothing compared to Erin. Nothing.
But her goal was 12. Her goal was 12. It's just she didn't save per month. Right. And I was just going to say, she made a lot of her goals to finish very specific projects or make very specific projects. And I tend to keep things on my more vague because my worry would be if I was like, okay, like let's say the typhoon. If I made that a goal and say, I want to knit the typhoon. And then say a couple months go by and I don't get to it. And then let's say by June, I'm like, you know what? I don't really like the typhoon anymore. Well, that's a very specific goal, right? So I try and make things a little more vague.
That's right. Yeah. So I learned from that, and I know what this year I'm going to do some changes for, so we're good.
Okay, so should I do mine?
Yes, you can do yours.
Okay, so my 2016 resolutions, and I completed about half of them, and I'm happy with that, because the first year I did it, I think I completed one. So
you only completed half of them?
About half, I think.
Oh my gosh, I don't feel that bad. They're like missing
out
by one.
No, not everybody finishes all of
them. Oh, I thought for sure you would have finished it. Oh, okay, I don't feel that bad at all.
I never finish all my goals.
Wow.
And I think maybe three people have completed their whole list.
Most
people
amazing.
Don't. So
oh, I didn't
it's
know
normal.
That.
Yeah,
okay, I don't
normal.
Feel that bad anymore.
Yeah,
you didn't tell me that.
There's no pressure. You're not. It's not like finish your list.
Tell me that.
Like it's just you know motivation. Like it's just supposed to be fun and people. You know, it's supposed
totally
to
told me that when I'm like I failed.
Sorry,
I didn't really fail then.
Sorry. No, you didn't fail. You only failed in your own head.
Oh God.
Anyway, no one thinks
it's not
you
that bad.
Okay, so my number one goal was for to, and I did and I didn't. We'll see. But stash mindfulness. So I wanted to just be very aware of my stash.
Oh, she was. She stashed it up.
I'm very aware of all the yarn I purchased this year. But I started off really good, actually. So I wanted to be more mindful of my purchases. And my goal was to queue a bunch of projects. Mm-hmm, that's right. And then assign yarn to those projects. And then any yarn that was left over that I didn't have plans for to sell. And I ended up selling 8,400, so almost 8,500 grams That's worth of yarn I sold, okay? And then I kept track all year of my grams in when I bought stuff and my grams out when I purchased. And my goal was basically at the end of the year that my grams out was less than my grams... My grams out was more than my grams in. And at this point, because I sold all that yarn, if I didn't sell all that yarn, I'd be screwed. But because I sold all that yarn, I haven't added in the yarn I showed last week.
Okay.
But even with that, I think I'm okay because it's still, I'd have to purchase.
Are you still under?
I'm still under because I figured out where I am right now, I'd have to purchase 30, like around 30 more skeins of yarn for it to be even. And I'm not going to purchase 30 skeins of yarn in a day.
In like 2 days, yeah.
Yeah, so that one I consider
Matt. That's good.
I consider that
perfect. Nice. That's a good one. That's a huge one.
Yeah. So number two originally was make Avery 3 matching sweaters for her doll and herself. So a kid's sweater and then a doll sweater.
Yes.
Okay? And then in June, I changed that out because I was like, I'm not going to do that. So I changed it out to spin and knit socks for my cousin. She's going on a trip.
Right.
Well, her trip's been moved to March. So it never became a priority.
Okay.
So I didn't do that. So that's getting moved to 2017. So that one was a... But that's okay.
Back to the sweater thing with Avery dolls, because you did that.
No, I didn't.
You made a sweater for Avery doll.
I said make 3 matching sweaters.
Okay, but you did... What did you do? One? Two?
One.
One.
And then I changed it, so it was no longer a quilt.
I know.
So it doesn't count.
So it doesn't count, but you still have to play
with them. So number three, make a scrappy quilt with bag scraps.
You totally did that.
I totally did that. I showed it
last time. That was the Hello Kitty one.
Yeah, I did that.
That was very nice.
Number four, make 6 projects with hand spun.
You did that too.
I did that. 5, learn double knitting. Did that.
Woohoo, did that.
6, finish owl blanket. Nope. But that's I've moved that to 2017.
Yeah.
And I've made it.
Hopefully we'll move to 2018.
No, but I've made it more vague.
Okay.
So you'll see when I do this.
Perfect.
7, make 6 pairs of socks. I've made 17.
Sweet. That's a great one.
8, spin 60 ounces. I did 66.5.
You almost tripled that, actually, your sock one. If you would have made 18, that would have been triple. Yeah. That's so
good.
Two
years ago, I only made 3 pairs of socks over the year.
That's amazing. Yeah. Sorry, what was the last one I just talked over? I apologize.
Spin 60 ounces, and I spun 66.5.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Very nice.
Okay, number 9, make monster pants for my friend's baby. My goal, it says Stacy's a new baby. Her baby's now 9 months old. And... No monster pants. So I've moved that 2000 to next year.
Are you still making monster pants?
Yeah, with the little monster, face. Because I'm going to try and make them for his first birthday.
That'll be still fun
to
wear.
Still fun. I moved that to next year. 10, make 3 samples for shows with hand-dyed yarn. And then I changed that out in June to make 1 full sock on 9-inch needles, which I did.
You did?
I did. My Koala socks.
You did? Totally.
11, finish a sweater for Dennis. Womp womp. Nope, womp. Didn't happen. But hopefully 2017? Next year, I'm hoping.
For Valentine's Day.
Yeah, Valentine's Day. I'm going to finish that sweater. And then number 12, make a wrap for mom. And see, I didn't say knit. I just said make. And I was hoping to have one for Christmas.
Is that the one you're making her?
I'm hoping to still.
Oh, you haven't done it yet?
I couldn't get to Fabricland, so I didn't buy the fabric.
Oh. Wait, weren't you supposed to go yesterday?
Yeah, but the weather was crap in the morning.
It was?
Yeah.
Oh.
Maybe it wasn't here, but it was...
I don't know. I told you I've been barricaded in my house.
We had, like, blizzardy type, whiteouty type
stuff. It was. You know why? Because my husband went out in a snowblower. That's right.
Yeah.
You're right.
Yeah. So I didn't go out yesterday. So if I can squeeze in a trip to the fabric store tomorrow morning, I might still do
it. You could totally do it.
I might still do it.
Why don't you do it all the way home now?
Because Dennis needs me to get home. Oh, my God. It's almost... I told Dennis I'd be home. Dennis needs me home to do work.
Oh.
We need to... I just looked at the time.
She's going
to
whip me.
Yeah. So number 12. So I'm hoping to still do that one.
Okay, yeah, okay. I think you can totally get that done.
Yeah.
And that'll be a nice gift for your mom.
Yeah.
Yeah, totally.
And there goes her tummy.
There's my stomach talking. I'm sorry if you hear that.
Okay, so 2017.
Oh my God, you got lots of resolutions, girl.
No, it's just 12.
I don't even have 12.
Well, I always make 12, though.
Okay.
You can add to them. You
I will still add to them. Yeah. I still got to finish them.
This is what she has right now. So do you want to do yours? You do
yours did you talk about your total resolution? So 2016, your total was?
Oh, projects?
Yeah.
what would you, 52 projects.
Yeah. I had 19.
I made 52 projects. That's 19. My most in the last couple 52. Years. Yeah.
That's amazing.
Next year won't be as much because I'm focusing on bigger garments, like bigger projects.
Yeah, and they take more time. They definitely do.
Okay, okay, so, let's do yours and then we'll do mine and then I need to.
So 2017, so far, these are things that I'd like to do and I'm going to add more because there's other things that I'm thinking now that I probably want to do now. Mm-hmm. So wording, it's about wording. I want to have 2 garments finished for next year. Finished.
So that includes whips then?
So that could be including whips, definitely. It has to be finished by next year. It could be started too, random ones.
Yep.
I want to finish 4 pairs of socks next year.
Okay. So she's doubling her, what you did this year. Like, new socks.
Yeah.
So you finished 2 socks. Oh, that would suck. Thanks
for the jinx turns. I'm using sock yarn, but I'm not making socks. So that would suck. So I need 4 pairs next year.
Okay, you can do that.
That's okay. 4 pairs. Somewhere within the whole year, I got to do 4 pairs so I can figure that out. I'd like to have between 15 to 20, and hopefully closer to 20, finished total projects. Like, all of them, including everything. This year I did 19. Excuse me. But I know it's not increasing by much.
But you're planning on doing bigger projects too, so.
But I have some bigger projects I want to do in there. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. And I want to organize my yarn cubbies.
Yeah.
So just because they're done and their yarn stuffed in these little cubby things in their, like they're in boxes, like in the...
Like those drawers.
Those drawer things that slide out of your IKEA things. So I have them in there. I want to organize them and on the fronts put labels. So depending on if I organize them by weight.
Or dyer, you were thinking.
Or by dyer. Yeah, by indie dyer, I can do that. Mm-hmm. So it's alphabetical. That would be kind of cool. So yeah, I'm not sure yet. But that I'd like to do this year. Make my name room functional. Okay. Now that's a huge one for me. Because I have a bed.
Right now it's just kind of a...
It's like a spare room.
Spare room, yeah.
Yeah. Not that I need it, because we have another spare room, but I have to sell all that stuff.
Yeah.
And so, yeah, I got it.
And then get some, like, furniture for, like, a little couch or something.
Yeah, set it all up so that it's a functional yarn room where I could put in, you know, my Swift and my yarn ball winder and have a little couch and a desk and stuff to work in there. So, yeah.
I think you can do that in a year.
I think so. My husband will be really happy.
Yeah, you have to get rid of that furniture and then it'll be easy.
He wants it gone. Yeah. So, yeah. And then my stash entries. So, it's going to be hard because I'm not purchasing anything online. So I'm trying not to. That's my goal for next year. But there is events, you know, that we could purchase at. There is travel. There is yarn crawls. Yeah. So, those are kind of all events and, you know, that I could purchase from, but I want to try to keep my stash at 185 or less.
By the end of the year.
By the end of the year. That means I need to knit lots out of my stash.
Yeah.
So even though I add more yarn in, as long as I'm knitting out of my stash. And so that's where I'm going to have to, even if I add, let's say 20 skeins in, it brings it back up to like, say, you know, 195. But if I knitted those 20 out of stash, then I'm good. As long as I didn't knit 20 out of something, like take something out of new, then I'm okay. Or 15 or whatever it is I picked. 15? I think I'm around 200 now, so I think that's 15.
About 15. I think you can do that.
So, add a stash. Add a stash. And January starts. January, February, I have 2 right out of stash right away. So, there's 2. So, that's going to be like a separate thing of saying, this is what I need out of stash, and this is what I needed from new.
Yeah, and I kept track of my grams. Like, in my notebook, I wrote down, every time I completed a project, I wrote it down and how many grams it was.
Right.
So that I could keep track of my grams out. And then I think I'm going to write down my purchases because I just kind of put it in here, but then I wouldn't remember, oh, did I enter that in already? Like, you know, did I keep track of that? So I'm going to write that down too.
Well, when I put my purchases in, I actually put the date when I purchased them.
And yeah, I'd still lose track of it.
But I'm going to write it what I want it, but for stash out, it's not, mine's not going to be based on grams.
No.
Mine's just going to be like, hey, I use the skein.
No, I did grams just because I wanted to make sure my in was right.
Excuse me. Yeah. So that's it for now.
Okay.
But I think I'm going to add some more.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. No, 6.
6.
6. So you need... She doesn't have to come up for 12. So she could stop there if she wanted, but...
I have 6. Yeah. But we'll see. There might be some other things that might be either more specific or... Which might bite me in the butt again. Or the wording might be better and I might... Or I might change some of these around. I'm not sure.
Unless if it's something... It's not bad to have something specific. It's just like if you know you want to do it.
Right. There's nothing new that I want to learn. Like there's no new technique this year that I want to learn. Brioche might be one, but it depends. You've done it already. Mm-hmm. I haven't. But there's yarn that I want to make mitts and a hat out of, and someone just came up with this year with a brioche mitt pattern, but it's not matching the hat.
Okay.
Okay. So if someone was to come up with a hat and matching mitt, like mitt pattern, mm-hmm. that was brioche, maybe I would do that because I have...
Say learn brioche.
I have yarn that I would like to use for that. Angora yarn.
Okay.
That I like to use for that. Okay. We'll see. So we'll see. I'm not sure if I'm going to add that yet or not. Depends what I'm in the mood for. Your turn.
My turn. Okay. So again, my number one is stash mindfulness. I'm going to keep track of my grams in and out again. This time I'm going to say my allowable purchases are half of what I knit out.
Wow.
Okay. So I'm not saying I can't buy yarn. It's so like if I make a project and it contained 500 grams of yarn, mm-hmm. I can purchase 250 grams of yarn and I don't have to do it right then. I can bank that.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah,
so I can bank, like, I'll just keep track of it, and I can bank it. So, like, if that's I all of a sudden want a sweater quantity, and I need 1,500, you know, whatever, I can see if I have that in mind.
Right.
Whatever. So I'm just going to keep track of that. I'm going to aim for more out than in by the end of the year, and then I'm doing the stash entries, too. So I would like my stash entries by the end of the year to be 175 or less for yarn.
Wow, that's good.
And 15 or less for fiber.
Okay, so what are you at right now, roughly, for your...
I'm a little over 200.
Okay, and you want to be down to 175, so that's good.
I'll be down by 175.
So that's probably about, what, 30, 35 skeins of yarn or so? Yeah, that's probably. Really good. And then your fiber is...
I'm at 22 right now, but I'm not spinning as much as I used to, so...
Okay. And you want to get down to, what was that?
15 or less.
That's still good.
Yeah.
That is still good. That's a lot. Spinning takes a lot to do because
It's more than 15. I didn't enter my totally inked yarn, that new one that I got. I'm at 17. I don't know, 16.
Heard your dealer.
Excuse me. All right, so number two. Cue 30 to 40 items that I want to make over the year where I already own the pattern and ideally have the yarn.
Wow.
And try to work from this list. So, and make at least half. So last year I cued everything, but then over the year I would add to my cue.
Right.
So I never knew how much of that original list I actually made. So this year, my goal is to use my queue as my project, like...
As a guideline,
because I don't need to strictly stick to that. I can make things, because I know new patterns are going to come out and stuff. So I queued 40 projects that go in line with what I want to make for the next year. I tried to pick things where I already own the pattern. I tried to things where I already own the yarn.
That's good.
And... I'm going to do that, you know, where you say start project. So
right.
It takes it out of your queue.
Yeah.
I'm going to do that, and I'm not going to add anything to my queue. So if something comes up that I want to make that's not in my queue, I can put it in my favorites, I can start it.
Right.
But I'm not going to add it to my queue because I want to see that number go down. I want to see how many of those 40 projects
that's good.
I make over the year. And I picked 30 to 40 because I knew I made this year 52.
Right.
So that gives me wiggle room. To make
some
projects.
New, exactly.
And I'm also going to be hoping to make more garments. So I might make less than that, but I queued 40. So I have 40. I have my 40 projects that I'd like to do, and I'm going to try and work from that list.
I have stuff in my queue that I actually have yarn put aside for, too.
So then you could do that, too. So three. Now, I changed this from when we last talked. Make 12 pairs of socks.
Oh. That's less.
Less.
We were talking more because
I was
gonna
do 17 again because I did 17 this year and I'm like, you know what, I want to make a lot of garments this year. I don't want to stress myself out making all these socks because I said 17.
It's okay.
So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna say 12 because that's one a month.
One for me.
And I'm pretty sure I can do one a month.
I
might do more than 12, but I didn't want it to be more
as
than...
As long as I have a pair, I'm good.
She's on the list, so don't worry about it.
As long as I have
so
a pair.
So 12
that's
patterns.
That's good. But that's good, because you're wanting to do a couple of garments in there. And
I want to do a lot of
garments. And a garment
could
take you, like, at least a month to do, depending on the garment, the detail you're doing, and the size of it.
Yeah.
And the yarns and stuff you're using. So sometimes take you a month and a half.
Yeah. So I just didn't want to be like, oh my God, I have to do my two pairs of socks a month, or I'm not going to keep up. So
if you're doing a finger-weight garment, that could take you a while.
Yeah.
I don't know why people would do that. That's a lot of
so number four, speaking of garments, number four is complete two garments for myself.
Perfect.
Because I don't make garments for myself. I want to make at least two. No, and it says complete. Notice that. See, this
yes,
is
yes,
complete.
Yes, complete two.
So I have one that's a whip that I started 2 years ago that I haven't finished
two.
Yet.
Two. I don't feel that bad anymore.
So if I finish that, that fits into this
that's
goal.
That's right.
Because I completed it, mm-hmm. right? So two. Finish it. So number five. Finish at least three whips from 2016 or earlier. So if I finish that sweater, that counts for two of them. Because it's a whip and it's a garment for myself.
Oh, that's right.
See how I did that?
And what in your husband's sweater? That would be the same thing.
That would be the same thing. So
it's not a garment for yourself.
No, but it would fit into the whips.
Yeah.
So instead of saying I want to finish this, 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 and this, I just said three whips so that the ones I finish, great. But the ones, like, let's say that poppy cowl I don't finish.
That's right.
then it doesn't matter because I just need to finish three whips that I have.
That's nice. Okay. That's good. That's a good one.
Okay.
I only have one whip going into the new year, by the way.
Yeah, but you don't tend to have a lot of whips.
No, I do. Not like her.
Number six, finish Dennis's Rowan sweater. So this is not the blue sweater. This is the one with that yarn that I ripped out.
Yeah.
This was the sweater from 2010 that he picked out the yarn for, and I made almost completely and then ripped it out because I didn't like it. And I'm making a new sweater. So I want to finish that sweater.
So that's to finish for this year, for 2017. Okay.
Okay. Number seven, complete 6 projects out of hand spun. So that's, I did that again.
Yeah.
And I just like that because you make hand spun and you put it away and it sits there looking all pretty. Mm-hmm. And this forces me to use some of it. So I'm doing this again.
Do you have enough hand spun? Because we talked about that.
Oh yeah, I have plenty.
No. Do you have enough hand spun to do a sweater or something for yourself or a cardigan?
I'd have to spin for it because I'd have to spin.
So, but you can do that.
If I spun for it. See? I don't have enough in my stash.
Look how many goals you just completed if you were to do that.
I'd have to blend a lot of different fibers to make it consistent.
Oh, don't you have enough from your drug dealing that you just purchased?
Not for sweater.
Okay.
I'd need several. I'd have to.
I wasn't sure.
Or I'd have to take a lot of my different fibers and blend them together to make one kind of color. But yeah. So 6 projects out of hand spun. I'm doing that again. So number 8. This is another one that I've changed since I talked to you. So last year I said spin 60 ounces.
Yes.
I'm changing it to spin 30 ounces.
Ooh, half of that.
Because I looked at it, and 60 ounces is about 15 to 17 braids of fiber, okay?
Right.
And if I make 6 projects, so basically I'm making more hand spun than I'm using in projects.
Right.
Right? And I want to try and
balance it out.
Balance it so that you're making it and using it. So I moved it to 30 ounces because
that's okay.
That would keep what I'm making and what I'm spinning about equal. So I'm not building up this giant pile of hand spun and then only making 6 projects.
But you also have more garments this year that you're looking to make. Yeah. So if you balance all that out and you've also taken less socks down because you're doing more garments, I think you'll be able to do that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So because I just made it this year. I think last year I spun almost 90 ounces. And this year I just made that 60 ounces.
Yeah, you did.
So I'm moving it down to 30. I'm just moving it down to 30 to keep things equal and just so that I don't burn myself out.
You know what? It's a good goal to set because you're setting yourself something that's realistic.
Yeah.
And if you exceed it, then it's even better.
Fun.
So, like, that's great.
But I'm not going to push myself to spin just to be that goal. Right. I'll just spin what I want to spin.
That's right.
Number 9, start a memory blanket and complete at least 50 squares. So I'm actually planning on starting 2. I want to start...
Not just 1, 2.
Because I want to start the Mydrid square blanket. And I've wanted to start it before. I just didn't know how it would fit into our, I don't want to say aesthetic, but, it wouldn't fit anywhere in our house where it would look like it belonged there. And then remember I was talking to you how I was like, oh, now I think I'm going to do it. I'm going to make it as something for Avery to take away with her when she moves away.
I think so.
The house. So
like
that
from
gives
college
me,
or something
that
like
gives
that.
Me, 15 years to finish this blanket. But then... When you do the mitered square, every time you do a square, you still have some left over.
Right.
So I'm going to do that crocheted one that everybody's doing.
Oh, that's
because you can just use all your ends.
Right.
So I'll put a square in the blanket, and then I'll put whatever's left from that square.
Sounds great.
Into the crochet one. So my goal is to, over the year to put at least 50 squares on that blanket.
That's the crochet blanket that Amber did from Yarn Hoarder, and that everybody's now following.
Andre Sue's doing, and Sue's doing, and everybody's doing.
So
it is
be,
really pretty great.
It is. It's pretty the way it knits up. And then if you can totally use
so over strap. Over time, I'll have 2 blankets.
But the blanket for Avery will be really nice.
Yeah.
Really nice.
Yeah. So I'm gonna cast that on in January. I gotta get that started. So number 10, make a sweater set for Nathan. So that's the from last year, the baby's the monster pants.
Right.
So
now you've added more to it.
Well, I was going to do a sweater set anyway.
Oh, okay.
So it's fine. I've already picked it. I already have the yarn. I bought the yarn.
So it's
going
to be sweater and monster pants.
Yeah, sweater and a monster pants.
Okay.
But we'll set for his first birthday, which is in March or April. It's either late March or early April. Spin and knit socks for Catherine. So that has been moved. So they're going on their trip in March. I have to get those done for March. And that will also count
Catherine
as a hands-on project. No, my cousin.
That Catherine. Okay.
Yeah.
Got it.
So that will count for that. So, and if I spin and knit them, that's also a handspun project.
That's
right.
And
it's part of my
socks.
30 ounces, right?
Nice.
And finally, number 12, make an African flower stuffy. Have you seen those?
I haven't seen those.
You haven't seen those? Oh, I didn't have one ready. So basically, they're the crocheted ones. Leslie made one. I think she did a sheep. Remember the sheep? So it's made of these squares.
Yes.
With the different colors. The hippos and the sheep.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that's what they're called.
And that designer, I think it's Heidi Bears.
I love that.
Heidi Bears is the designer. Has all kinds of animals. I love them all. And I just can't decide which one. I want to make one. I've been wanting to make one for years. I just don't know which one to make, but I'm going to make one of them this year.
Nice. Yeah. Who are you making it for?
Avery? I don't know. I might make it for Avery, or I showed them to my brothers, because I was like, you know what, I just want to make one, but
they're
don't.
They're pretty big.
They can be, depending on your yarn.
Yeah.
And my brother liked, there was two of them he liked, and I was like, well.
Which ones did he like?
He liked the frog prince.
Yeah.
There's a frog with a little crown.
Awesome.
And there's a turtle. And I was like, okay, I could see the turtle being like a pillow, because it was like a sea turtle.
Oh, that'd be cool.
So yeah. I might make one of those and give it to them for Christmas next year, because then I made it.
Or a pair of socks with that.
I don't know, we'll see. But then I've made it, but I don't have to keep it, because I'm going to wear
it. Right, it doesn't say you have to keep it, you just have to make it.
And Avery's not really into knit stuffies.
Oh, okay.
So if I made her one, I would give her just my sit somewhere.
I gave her my stuffie that I made.
Yeah.
Maybe B8, because I wasn't going to keep it.
Yeah, so I don't know if I'll make one for her, or I might make one for
Or myself. You can make one, as a footrest. Like a footstool.
I'd have to stuff it with,
super stuffing.
Super dense stuff. No, I'm not going to do that. But,
I love those. I think she made the hippo.
Yeah, I didn't know that's what they were called. Made the sheep. I'm pretty
sure. Was it the sheep?
She might have made both, but I thought I saw the sheep in the background.
But I love those. Yeah, I didn't know that's what they were called. I had no idea. I just know what they are.
I've loved them since I've loved them for years.
And they're super cool.
Yeah, and I just want to make one.
Yeah, they're awesome.
So if you guys have a vote on which one I should make, tell me.
Well, it depends what you want to do for it.
I don't know. I just want to make one.
Yeah, but if your brother wants one and he wants either the frog
but
or
I might not make it for him.
Turtle.
Maybe I don't want to make a frog.
But that's what I'm saying. If they want something, you want to make it for them, then you have to pick between the two that he wants.
Yeah.
And if not, then totally. Yeah. We could put up a thread for them and see what people like.
Maybe I'll pick my top or do five.
And do a poll.
And I'll do a poll and people can vote on which African flower animal I should make.
I didn't know that's what they're called. That's cool. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm trying not to cough, and that's why I keep drinking, so that I don't cough.
Those are my resolutions.
That's excellent.
And so that thread is going to be started in the Bling Your String group if you want to join.
Yes. Go and join. It's fun. Mm-hmm. You know, it made me, obviously, knit more this year, because...
I had direction.
I had something that I wanted to do, and I knew, this coming year, we have stuff planned, a couple things planned for this year, but we don't have everything planned for this year. So that's why it's good to have some ideas of what you want to do. Try to get some projects
completed. And make them flexible so that you can kind of, even though you set these goals over the year, if your interests change, you can still make your interests fit into your original goals because they're not set in stone, very specific. I want to make this project with this yarn, with this on this.
I learned not to do that. But I didn't do that specific. Yeah. I mean, I did have some, but I mean, still, it's fun to do and...
Oh my God. I like it. There's people in my group who have done it every year since I've started doing it. And it's just fun. And like I said, there's little monthly prizes if you finish a goal, whenever you finish a goal in the month. And then there's a grand prize at the end. So
I never did those, did I?
You didn't enter. You didn't put...
I don't think... Do I win?
Technically, do I win? Not really, it's not your group, so you could. I think there are some that you entered in monthly that you were I finished this. And then I put your name down,
Oh, I know. I didn't. I just stopped entering them because I was just I didn't think I win anything anyways. Yeah. But I was gonna put. I was just gonna put it in for the year just to say this is what I completed and edited.
Yep. I keep track of it in a Google spreadsheet and stuff. So is that enough? Yammer.
We yammered on for a little bit too much. We're good. We got it all. You guys now all know what's happening for 2017.
Yeah, and next time we'll be able to show you the start of our stripey objects. I think we're both starting socks, so our starting socks.
I think our podcast will be in about 2 weeks' time. So not the first week of January, but the second week of January we'll be into it. And it will give you guys time that if you're joining on the Sock Cals, to definitely start it. Mm-hmm. New Year's Eve cast on. New Year's Day cast on.
Yeah.
And at least you have something. And I know in 2 weeks some people can finish a pair of socks. That won't be me.
I have other stuff. I need to finish my mother-in-law sweater. I don't want that to drag on. I just want to get that done now. So
of course.
I'm going to cast on the socks, and that's what I'm going to work on my mom's. But after that, when I'm at home, I'm going to try and work on Dennis's sweater and his mom's sweater.
Well, I want to finish this cowl that I'm making for a gift, and I'm going to try to work on that today, tomorrow.
Yeah.
New Year's Day cast on will be my socks from Desert Vista Dye Works, and I think I'm going to do them two at a time this time.
Okay.
So that... maybe they knit up slower, but they knit up evenly.
And they knit up when you're done, you're done.
Yeah, exactly. I'm done. And if I can do fish, if I can do afterthought heel, then all I have to do is put the waist yarn in, because I don't know how to do it otherwise.
You just cut. I can show you if you want to learn. Maybe that you can make that a resolution.
Great.
I can show you how to cut my sock. It's so easy. It's so easy.
Yeah, it's not. I find it's not the cutting. It's just picking up the stitches.
No, it's so you don't understand. It's so easy because like I find the thing when you put it in the waist yarn, you have to put your heel there, right? Whereas
yes,
if
you
finish
you
your
to.
Sock and you measure it, you're like, okay, then you measure where to put your heel. Like you can change it, or depending on the heel you want to use, you might need to put it in a different spot. Whereas when you use waist yarn, you're stuck with that spot.
So you know
and
what?
If you
you're absolutely right, because my socks are too long for me.
Yeah.
Because I was trying to judge it and everybody kept saying, go up to your ankle bone, do this. And you don't really know where you need it done.
And I find it easier to measure from your toe. Like, I know it's about 8 inches for my brother's.
Right.
So I measure from the toe up 8 inches, and I know that's where I'm going to put the heel. So I find it easier to do, like, not put the waist yarn in. So you should make that a goal.
You know
so
what? Maybe I will.
Yeah,
because at least then I can put it as a goal. I can always say I've been there, done that kind of thing.
It's so easy.
And,
so
yeah. Because you know what? Picking up the stitches last time, I was at SSK, and the girls helped me pick up the stitches there.
And you're not even really picking up the stitches. You're putting your needle through already existing stitches.
Right. Well, that's what you do with the other one, too. Because the waist yarn is there, so you're picking up those existing stitches.
I know,
stitches.
But then you have to... So
but it was still hard. Like, it was still
hard.
Not that hard. And I was getting holes on the sides.
Definitely.
These won't have holes, right?
Well, you just have to... It depends on what kind of heel you have.
Okay.
Yeah, so I think you should...
Okay, we'll see. There's the 2017. There's something I'm going to add to my list now and get that done.
Yeah.
So...
So we'll see you in the new year.
We'll see you in the new year.
Yeah.
Happy New Year. Wish everyone a healthy, happy, prosperous new year.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you again for watching us. Thank you for coming back, your return viewer, and if you're new one, don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube
button.
Our
box is building.
It is building. We're going to have some great goodies in there for our 500 giveaway.
Mm-hmm.
And don't forget to check the group. Thank you so much. Anything else you want to say?
I don't think so.
All right. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Bye.